warning time.
Warning time, Diesel. You got the same look on your face I do? What in the world's going on?
Oh, I hate mornings. Actually, you know what? I love mornings. I hate the waking up process. For the first, like, 10 minutes, you're just like, huh? Who? What? Why? Why? So it was dark when we got here last night, but apparently a lot of the trees here don't have leaves on them again. So we're up here in West Virginia, near Burnsville, West Virginia, just north of it. It's amazing how quickly the climate change is going north. Like, there was greenery just yesterday. Oh, well, let's get ready to go here, have some breakfast, walk this weasel figure I got over here. Hey, weasel. You. Hey. You want to go outside? Oh, I figured you did. Beautiful nature. This is the same bush we were looking at yesterday, but we weren't going to go in there because there could possibly be death man-eating spiders in there. So we didn't.
Looks like it would have been fun, though.
There's no spiders. It gets too cold at night. They all die.
They all go into hibernation or whatever. Look at that big blob floating in the sky over there. That's a bird nest.
Wouldn't that be cool just to be able to live in a treehouse?
We found this nice open grass area back here. This Diesel's just going for a rip.
It's nice. I like when I can do that, because then he actually goes, you know? He doesn't always go when I'm right beside him, because, you know, he's like any normal person. He likes to be as far away as possible when he does his business, because, you know, it's private. You don't want your master right there while you're dropping a big one. Totally understand.
Is there a dog out there, man? Is there a dog?
Yeah, I think it's a dog, man. It's a little fur ball. I can't quite make out what it is, but I think it's a dog. Who is it? He's right there, man. It's a little white fur ball. It might be a very furry cat, though. I'm not sure, man.
Well, we're in a nice little narrow road here. Isn't this fun? Still in West Virginia. And raining out, so the camera outside there is all full of raindrops, so you're stuck inside here with me. Look at that house up on the hill up straight ahead of us.
Whoa!
That's ginormous.
Wow!
Oh, I wish there was a shoulder here so I could pull over and zoom in on that thing. Wow! Beautiful house. Hill too. My truck is trying to figure out what is going on. Transmission's all confused. What happened to the flat road? Hey.
It's 700 meters. Turn right onto I-79 north.
10-4, Mandy. Wow, what a house. It's called Goshen Grove Estates. Oh, it's a bed and breakfast. Oh, okay. That's not someone's house, it's their business too. I see. This fine little mist keeps falling down here. Oh, it bugs me. Oh, this is my happy time. It was payday yesterday, and here's Walmart. Those two things combined make me a happy man. Even with this rain. It'd be better without the rain, quite honestly. You always know that there's truck access to a Walmart because they have to get their stuff here somehow, right? So you know trucks come in here, and every Walmart truck is a 72-foot unit. So if they can get in here, I can get in here. I always just go around to the back, and you see, they always have lots of room to turn around because they need room to turn around for their trucks, right? You want to make sure that wherever you park is well out of the way. And some Walmarts still don't like it if you park there, but you are a customer, so they do sort of have to let you in there if they can accommodate you. I wouldn't go and park in a Walmart parking lot unless you're gonna buy something there, though. That's just rude. You take up a lot of space, you know? If you're gonna take up that much space, at least go in and buy something. Walmart's a good place. There's something for everyone in there. Go in there and buy a candy bar or something. I always just find a spot in the back somewhere and park my rig out of the way. I try not to park where they don't want me to. Like here on the right would be a great spot to park, but they have those lines there. They don't want us to park there. So I found another good spot here on the left on my way in. And I'm gonna park right here in these parking spots. Lots of room. I wouldn't park here overnight, but I'm gonna go in there and spend some money. So unless if they don't want my money, they shouldn't have a problem with this. There's no signs here posted saying no trucks parking, no nothing. Sometimes, 1 second here. Sometimes they'll put signs up that say no overnight parking, right? Because they want your money, okay? They'll never tell you that they don't want your money. So as long as you're gonna spend money there and you're out of the way, they don't mind. But it's when you come here and park here overnight and plug up their parking lot for their rush in the morning and stuff, then they start getting a little, you know, upset at you. So if at all possible, park at a truck stop or a rest area for night. Don't park at a Walmart for night. Unless if you like are familiar with that area. You know what I mean though, right? Just don't be an inconvenience to others. That's pretty much what I'm trying to say. Wherever you are, think about others, especially when you park overnight. We got big units, and it's not that they don't like truckers, it's just we take up a lot of space. Sometimes we get in the way if we park in the wrong spot for too long. And sometimes they don't like our heavy trucks sinking into their nice soft asphalt in the hot summer days, then we leave ruts and we damage their parking lot. I can understand why they don't want that too, but hey, truckers need to eat too. All right, Diesel, you stay here and guard the fort, okay? I'm gonna go in there and have some fun. Sorry they don't let you in there, man. They still don't consider you a service animal. I know you're a navigator, but they just don't understand, man. I'm working on it. I'll talk to them, okay? I'll put in a good word for you. Good boy. So yeah, as a truck driver, if you're gonna park at a store like this, you can expect to park at the back and have to walk. But hey, I'm not complaining, we're truck drivers, right? We need the exercise. So you see, I'm not that far away from the building. It's over there. So it's not like I'm that far away. Look at Diesel in there. See you later, Diesel. He's gonna guard the truck to make sure those crazy Walmart criminals don't hijack it. Because that's the first thing someone thinks of when they come to Walmart. Let's rob a truck. When there's a perfectly good store you can rob right there. Now I'm just thinking weird, I know. Okay. Speed walk, right? We need to speed walk. Get the heart pumping, speed walk. The faster we get into Walmart, the better. I'm gonna go in the little door because they left it open. Why not? Because I'm crazy.
It's November 1st today. The day after Halloween and all the Christmas stuff is out. Should I decorate my truck for Christmas, guys? Thinking about it. I'm like putting like a lighted Santa face or something. Or a lighted wreath on my grill. No? Cheesy?
Excited, Christmas is coming.
I'd like a wreath that says Merry Christmas. But it's hard to find anything that says Merry Christmas. Well, here's one. I don't want a silver one. They all say like seasons, greetings, and peace, and happy holidays.
It's not happy holidays, it's Merry Christmas. Let me put this thing on.
What do you think? Yeah, it's funny. All kinds of stuff here.
So, I think I'm getting a wreath here. A wreath, and in the center of this wreath, from behind it, it's gonna have this.
So it's gonna come in behind the reef, so it'll be in the middle, right? We got some pre-lit garland in there. Gonna wrap around with this stuff. We're going all Christmassy this year. You can't forget the nativity scene. This is what Christmas is all about. That's my chair right there.
America.
Dang it, guys.
Dang it.
It's not really that much. It's just a lot of big stuff. You know, like a bunch of water here for diesel. I decided to get him new jugs because his old jugs kept refilling, but they're getting old. I don't like to use jugs that long. And these have better caps. So I bought him some new jugs of water, food, and just a couple of Christmas things. They're just really big Christmas things. So not like it's that much. I mean, there is some water down there too and some Pepsi Max. But it was just a few bags of stuff. It wasn't that much, right? Right? I think I did pretty good. Self-control. Controlled myself? I think so.
Seriously, man?
Alright, let's get out of here. Let's blow this popsicle stand. Right after we stop for this stop sign. Then we'll go. And that one over there. Wait, they don't have a stop sign. Good thing I realized that. I'm wondering, why aren't they stopping?
Snow, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, dogs and cats, that is snow. And yes, we're here at the Pilot. No loves to fuel light around here, and I just can't turn my back on Pilot Flying J. I just can't. They've been so good to me, and they got such a good network. Like, they're everywhere, and they're in both sides of the border. That's why I like Pilot Flying J so much, is because they're in Canada and the United States. So I get to gain points on both sides of the border. One thing I don't like about Love's Rewards program is at the end of the year, if you do not fuel up to 10,000 gallons, you lose all your points at the end of the year. Seeing as it's November already, I can't. It'd be very hard for me to get to 10,000 gallons by the end of the year. I just lose all the points I was earning anyways. Pilot doesn't have that. Their points stay on till the next year. That wins my business. Their Royalty Rewards program, I think, is one of the better ones. I like it anyways, everyone likes different things, but I am still a 100% Pilot Flying J supporter, patron, and loyalist, I guess you would say. I can't turn my back on them. I just can't. Glug, 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 glug.
He's thirsty. He's thirsty. Cold enough to break out the toque. What do you guys think?
US$124, $471.
All right, I don't know how this is gonna turn out, but I think there's some pretty cool colors on this bridge coming up here. This is Peace Bridge. It's the bridge.
46 Peace Bridge Plaza, on right.
Thanks, Mandy. It's the bridge connecting Buffalo, New York, USA, to Fort Erie, Ontario, Canada. So once we get to the middle of this bridge here, be in Canada. Fancy little bridge here, changing colors and stuff. That down there is Canada, and we'll see you on the other side. Bada bing, bada boom, baby. And we're in Canada. We crossed the line, Diesel. We crossed the line. Now I gotta figure out how to get out of this customs complex here. Wait, oh, nope, that is a yield sign. I shall yield. No one to yield for. Then we give her. Oh, it's getting dark here now. Oh, my camera's not gonna pick this up. That's no fun. Welcome to Ontario, everybody. I'll see you when I stop. Well, Diesel, that's the end of the day, isn't it? That's the end of the day. Tomorrow should be an exciting day, as we're probably gonna be setting up some of our Christmas stuff tomorrow. I love Christmas. So thanks for joining me today, guys. Tomorrow is another day. We're gonna make another vlog tomorrow. We're gonna be sitting right here. We're gonna be, yeah, sitting right here pretty much. I don't know, maybe we'll do some laundry again. Woo, exciting. No, but we're gonna be sitting here talking about Christmas decorations and setting them up in here. So it should be pretty fun, pretty interesting. See what I come up with in here. Those of you who love Christmas can maybe give me some pointers down below in the description of tomorrow's video. See what else I can add to it, because I want to keep adding to it up until Christmas. Other than that, guys, thanks for watching today. Go down below to the description. There's a bunch of links of vlogs from the past. I've been doing this a long time, and I've included vlogs all the way up to a year ago, even though I've been vlogging about 3 years now. So if you go down below, you can see them there. There's a whole bunch of links to all kinds of other stuff, of Trucker Josh stuff and whatnot. And you can go check it out, see what you like. Been there already? Good job. If you're new to the vlogs, that's for you. All right, we'll see you tomorrow. Say goodbye, Diesel. Say goodbye. Hey, how are you? Say goodbye to the good people.